But the women are, in a way, the better version of the men. Yeah. Right? When you are in a couple, you see the better version. Yeah, the man sees the better version in the woman. Yeah. There can be exceptions, but mostly it is like this. Yeah. And for this reason, the Prophet said, the wise man follows his wife. Yeah. Or the best among them, among my people, is the one who treats his wife the best. No. Yeah. And through a woman, the man can experience his better or his worst. Both possible. No. He will probably have these two experiences. He will have the heaven, the best version. He will see himself in very high, and the way around. And this is the game of the two forces. Yeah, that they come from the three to the six, to the three to the six, to the three to the six, all the time. And now look, yeah, in the Book of Love, the what is called the heart of the Quran, no, is the Surah Yasin, and this is the 36th Surah. Isn't it interesting? Yeah, it's the 36th Surah, right? So again, in this surah, there is this secret of this dynamic. And for this reason, we are supposed to recite it every single day. Yeah. It is recommended to recite it every single day, read it every single day, because it will give you a certain kind of balance, a certain kind of diminishing the force of the game. No. We cannot stop it. Yeah. We cannot run out of it, but we can bring it very, very, very much down, no? And we're coming now in this time where we're in front of the next technological jump that will confront us again with very, very different challenges that we can see now, yeah. And it is coming fast, no? When Steve Jobs launched, I think in 2003, he launched the iPhone. Yeah. Then maybe some of you had it, yeah, later. And if you had been the user of one of the first iPhones, you understood quickly it wasn't very usable. Yeah. It was not really functioning very well. It was not really the thing, no? And so someday they changed back to the thing with the buttons, no? And it was like almost coming home again, no? Yeah, you felt it. Ah, we can press buttons again, no? And that stayed a bit like till the third one came out. Yeah, also interesting, it's the third one, no? That the first one wasn't good, the second one wasn't really much better, the third one was a breakthrough, no? And at that moment, because it was not good in the beginning, the company, Nokia, yeah, company, the company Nokia was not realizing what has happened to them. Yeah. So they looked at it, they probably had it in their hand and they said, wow, it's interesting, but it's like, it's a bit useless. No. They could not understand the whole dynamic of what has happened, right? They just couldn't understand it. And they were the number one company in making mobiles, yeah. And they were like indefeatable, no? And then this Apple people that made computers and that was it basically, no? They came with this phone, And they could not see what will come over them. Well, it took them exactly these 2 years till there was the number three. And after that, they were finished. Completely finished. Yeah. They were falling from the highest point. Yeah. It was an incredible, valuable company, no? And to zero, bang. Now it's finished. There's not no Nokia anymore, right? And they couldn't believe it. I think they cannot believe it until today. Yeah. And now they invented the next one. Yeah. And this is what is it called? Vision Pro or whatever. And this is a thing that allows you to be in the computer somehow. No, you have the computer in the room, right? And you can do many things. And you would say, well, Microsoft has invented that, Google has invented it, or all of them have it already. But what's the difference? No, what is the difference? There's a huge difference, you see. And the difference is that this time it's not about gaming or about whatever. It is really bringing your projections into reality. Yeah. That you have a real feedback, that you get interactive with another reality, let's say, yeah, in a completely new way, and you will see what will happen. Yeah, might be not this year, not next year, but give it not too much time, it will explode. And it could be, yeah, that not in a far time we all run around with those things, no? Because it's not about gaming only, you see, it is about the possibility to create in another dimension. Yeah. And it's thrilling. It will be a thrill. It will, on the creative side, it will open a new art, a new whatever, you know. Yeah. Very, very mind-blowing, I can say. Yeah. The question is not if it is good or bad. You see, we have to go away from the 3 and the 6. Now we want to go to the 9. So the question is not, is it good or bad, you know? Yeah. It is always both, as we are always both, because we live in the 3, in the 6. We are living in these forces. Yeah. So when you ask yourself, am I good? You can say, yes, something in me is good. Yeah. And something is not good. Yeah. Right. Till you reach beyond good and bad, where Rumi said, meet me in a place beyond good and bad. Yeah. But there will not be many people in your life that you meet that there are beyond good and bad. Yeah. So some represent the good party. Yeah. Thank you very much for all of you. You represent the good party. No. As some, they will represent a not so good party. And also thank you for them. Yeah. Because one cannot be with the other, without the other. Right. Yeah. So we will be catapulted in a new dimension where we for the first time project something that we can't even know it at the moment, you know, what it will be and how it will interact and so on and so on and so on. But it will be a very, very new thing. Science, we come to new understandings and so on and so on. And maybe it is what we need to sort out our catastrophic situation, yeah, that we have created, no? We don't have to look everything as one disaster after the other, and everything collapses, and we are ending up in the complete apocalypse. You know, you can also see it very different. Yeah. The apocalypse is not something necessarily negative, you know. It doesn't mean that every just thing comes to ashes, yeah. And there will be a few cells that they survive, and they will become the new man or whatever, no? Yeah. Or a new, or someone who was living in the ice cave they survived and then they can come out and they whatever. No, doesn't mean necessarily that. It can just mean that we get to a complete new understanding, yeah. And everything changes. And how this changes, you see, when you are in the third dimension, you can, for example, not really comprehend, yeah, how the sixth one will look like, you know. And certainly you cannot comprehend what would be the ninth, no, yeah. And because of that, because we cannot embrace it with our mind in that way, we cannot think of a solution. We cannot think how it would be, because our all wishes and all our emotions stick with our projections of having a nice house, a nice family, a nice earth, no, a beautiful earth, and all that, right? Yeah, still a car, a nice whatever, you know. But there is something that we can only think in this projection. We cannot think it different, no. And that's why we are so panicking to hear that there could come a complete transformation and a complete change, no? Yeah. We cannot follow it, we cannot look at it. It is like our body goes from here and we don't know to which dimension, to how it will be really, really, right? We cannot know it. And maybe it's also not for everybody the same, no? So you may not fear death, but you feel the unknown, right? To a certain point, the mind has to feel the unknown, because the unknown is the death of the mind, no? And to die physically is one thing, but to die in your mind, no? To die in everything that projects all the time and cannot do that anymore, because it doesn't know the screen, yeah? It doesn't know how it will look like. Yeah, that is die before you die. Yeah, that means to really transform. Yeah, to somehow go through these threatening experiences. Yeah, that there is nothing you can hold anymore. No, and this is described that in the night of Qadr, in the night of power, it's called the night of power. Yeah. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he received the Book of Love. And the way it happened was through a mental crash. Yeah. He had a complete crash. And he described it after. He described it that the angel came down and pressed him, and then he said to him, read. It is written actually in the Book of Love. Yeah. And they have to find words, but the experiences when these forces are coming over you are indescribable. No. Right. And the same happens when you come to heaven. You can't really understand what is heaven, but when you come to hell also, you cannot understand what is hell before you experience both. No. Thank you.
this way love.